Today I felt higher than ever while driving. I was listening a very interesting interview to some guy called Panicker. Very interesting last name. And it's the first time I've been aware, or I did it on purpose, meditating while driving. Because I've been doing it all my life, but never on purpose. Yeah, so many people have it. When you feel like, hey, where am I? Where did all this time go? When you are, you are in another dimension. Only if you felt, everybody has felt that one way or another. The interesting thing is when you feel it in many different ways, and especially when you are aware of that, and you can even do it on purpose. Oh my God, I'm going snorkeling with this horrible wind. Oh, snorkeling, an amazing way of meditation. Walking. When I went to Thailand, it was amazing because I knew many days I said, okay, this is the reason why I came. I went there for many reasons, but none of them were there. In there, I got the reflection and I could infer or just bring from the supraconscious, from the cloud, from the Akashic registers, whatever they want to call it. It has no name. It's just for humans to understand what we people who can access to other perspectives, dimensions, call it whatever you want. It's nothing like that. It's just everybody has felt this in their life, which is not knowing about time. But I invented everything on my own. I haven't followed anything. So when I went to Thailand and I didn't know that there was a walking meditation, most of the people don't know if you are not into that. And I was not into that. I'm not into Buddhism. But I went there to see what I could learn as technique. I didn't learn anything, just the opposite. I already brought many experiences because, oh, so you can walk meditation. People were surprised. But 2 years before, knowing that, I started, but I did it many years before, but when I was aware and doing it on purpose, it was walking, eyes closed meditation. Because walking meditation is nothing compared to walking, eyes closed, but meditating. It's not walking, eyes closed. It's not trying to orientate yourself. No, it's to surrender to the infinite nothingness. And you can walk because before you saw around that there is no killing obstacles. So your survival mode can be disconnected. But when you are meditating, it doesn't mean that you are losing the attention of something if you don't want to, because you want to survive. But by being connected that way, you can never reach Nirvana. Nirvana is when you are not connected at all with your rational and emotional world. Rational and emotional is just the two sides of the same coin. Where I'm living this life is much above that. So I'm not following any teachings, which is good. I'm not against that. But it will never take you here. And when I was listening to this Panicker in this interview, I learned so many things, but they are rational things. I didn't learn anything. I learned to put a name of something that I was complaining about myself, because I don't know how to put the best words into these feelings, into these experiences. And there is a word, hermeneutica, Hermetisk. It's a Greek. Hermes is the god of the messenger. And what I am doing with migrant soul is just this hermeneutic thing. Because migrant and journey and Hermes and Ulysses are all the same thing. You don't need to know all the philosophy and history of all the religion to know better than the people who are writing about it what it is heaven, what it is nirvana. Because even though they are at different levels, if you think one is better than the other, it's because you don't know which one is the only real one. The only real one is when you know it. When you are so true to yourself that you know it. So you have to break all the mental barriers in order to accept that the paths are always unlimited. If you don't feel that, it doesn't matter how much you learn, how much you read. You must be on the other side to live that life. And maybe you can pretend you are like the rest of the people from time to time.